Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website, that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for September the 16th of 2019, well, it is titled A Lunar Corona Over Turin. So what is the corona? Well, corona can be a number of different things in astronomical terms. One is the outer atmosphere of the sun. In this case, though, we're looking at the moon, and the moon does not have an atmosphere, but the moon's light does pass through the Earth's atmosphere, and therefore can be distorted in various ways. And this is one of the things that we look at. You can get this rainbow color around the moon when you look at it through certain types of clouds. And in fact, very specifically, clouds that have very similar sized little water droplets. And the cloud, of course, has to be mostly transparent so you can see through it. Very thick cloud, of course, would not be able to do this because it would block out most of the moon's light. But a very thin cloud, it will diffract, the water droplets will be diffracted around, the light will be diffracted around the water droplets. So it's a different effect than the rainbow. A rainbow is caused by reflection within a water droplet. So light bounces off the inside of the water droplets and then is split into its component colors, and when that happens many times we get the rainbow that we will see. In this case, it is diffracted around the water droplets, and it is much more of a quantum mechanical effect, and really is about the only quantum mechanical effect that we can really easily see with the naked eye. So something that you can actually see the effects of quantum mechanics, which really generally talks about the subatomic level. So dealing with individual subatomic particles and things on even smaller than the atomic scale, so very, very small scales. And that's what we're seeing here with those water droplets and the thin clouds up there. As the light from the moon passes around them and gets diffracted around them, and diffraction is kind of a bending and distorting of the light as it comes through. We can get this with light waves in things like telescopes, and diffraction is one of the reasons we get a star-like pattern on many stars when we look at them through large telescopes. In this case, we are seeing something a little bit different, but it is also another type of diffraction that is bending all of this light and therefore giving us the different colors. Now, why do we get different colors? Well, that's the similar effect to the rainbow. Each color has its own distinct wavelength. So reds are longer wavelengths, down through the blues and the violets with the shorter wavelengths, and different wavelengths of light are diffracted or bent by differing amounts. And that allows the colors to then be split up much as they are within a rainbow, and as we see in our picture today in the corona around the moon. So that was our picture of the day for September the 16th of 2019. It was titled A Lunar Corona Over Turin. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be exoplanet water vapor. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.